yourself on camera, huh? So, all right, so I paid $2,125 for 600 pens where I got a 2010 Ford trade discount. Assume that I didn't get any early payment discount, I just paid it on the net. And so what I want to know was, well, what price should I set for each of these pens, because I want to figure out what the suggested retail price was, and I can't figure it out. Because all I got is the invoice for how much I paid, right? Because that's all I saved, because I was an idiot. So how do I go back to figure that out? So I wrote this check. I have the 600 pens. I know what my trade discount was. How do I go back to figure out what price to set my pens at when I go sell them? So, remember, folks, that this, what is this? List price or net price? It's net price. Why is it net price? That's what I paid. Remember the difference, right? List price is that suggested retail price value. It's how much you're going to collect. Net price is how much you paid. So my net price is the $21.25. So really what I want to do is to get back to the list price, because that'll tell me what my suggested retail price was for each pen. Now, how do we figure out what the net price is? Remember your formula. The net price equals the list price times the net price equivalent rate. So we have this variable. We want to figure out this one. How do we get this one? How do we find the net price equivalent rate? Yes? Exactly. Your net price equivalent rate is the product of all of your complements. So 80, 90, 96. Whew. Remember to convert those to decimals. 0.8 times 0.9 times 0.96, what'd you guys get? 6912. Okay. So now I have two of the three pieces of information I need. Now I can get the third one using my brain. So plug this in here, plug this in there, and then I just have to solve for my net my list price. So 2125 equals my list price times 0.6912. How do I get my list price by itself? Divide. So what's 2125 divided by 0.6192? 3634, so rounded to the nearest penny, $3,074.36. Awesome! Am I done? Why am I not done? Right, I wanted the suggested retail price of each pen. This is the suggested retail price of all of the pens. So, the price of each pen is going to be that number, 3,074.36, divided by, how many were there? 600. What price am I going to set for each of my pens? $5.12. So this is going to be a really, hopefully a very nice pen at $5.12. Oh, sorry. deflects the 9 and the 1. Potential test problem? Yes. All right, so how about the next one on that page? So I bought 500 shirts for $5.55 each. There should be an each on there, just so you know. FOB shipping point with a discount of 10.98 in terms of 210 and 90, period. The shipping was $200, the invoice, blah, 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 blah. All right, so what does FOB shipping point mean? Paid for by the buyer. We are the buyer. We have to pay for the shipping. Okay? Buyer pays shipping. Okay, so we have to make sure that we take care of that $200. All right, so what am I going to calculate first given this problem? Start with the list price, right? You don't have to calculate all of this stuff. My advice, though, is go through the process, right? $27.75, is that what you said?
Yeah.
Black is not doing so good. All right, so how am I going to get my net price? $27.75 times. Essentially the net price equivalent. Remember how we get that. Times 0.9, times 0.91, times 0.92, because our chain discount is 10.98. So, what's my invoice bill going to tell me I owe? Somebody crank that out for me. 20.90.91. Okay. So now I have my net price. The invoice date was the 28th, and I received my goods on the 4th. I pay the bill on the 14th. Which date am I going to use given those terms? Which one? Which date do I use, folks? The invoice date or the received goods date? It's standard, so which one do we use? Invoice date. Okay, so one of the first things you should have seen done once you saw those terms was, since it didn't say ROG up there, take the received goods date, scratch it out, right? So, is May 14th within 10 days of April 28th? So, there is no discount on this. So, am I going to write my check for $2,090.91? Why not? Don't forget the shipping. So again, remember the three types of terms. This one showed you the standard terms where there is no three characters at the end of it. That just means days from the invoice date. All right, so flip that page over. I bought 500 toasters, $9.99 each, suggested retail price, with 30-12-5-2 discount. In terms of 210 N90 EOM, what does EOM stand for? End of month. What's special about end of month? You get an extra month. And yeah, if it's after the 25th, remember to add that extra month. So normally what you do with EOM, find the month of your invoice, go to the end of that month. Unless the date is the 26th or after, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, then you actually add another month to that and then go to that end of the day, end of that month. And then however many days are after that based on your terms. So, what's my list price? How many did I buy? 500 or 5,000? 500 times 999, 49.95, is that what you said? Okay. How am I going to get my net price? $49.95 times my compliments. 0.7, 0.88. What are the other ones? 9.5 and 0.98. So what's my net price? $0.61, is that what everybody got? Okay. I make a payment on July 9th for $1,500. How much do I owe after that payment? Pay $1,500 on 7/9. Am I getting a discount on that $1,500? Yes. Why? Pay within the first 10 days, right? So the invoice date is 5/27, right? That's after the 25th. So go to the end of that month and then tack on an additional month. So my invoice date is really like it's June 30th. Right, remember that when we receive the goods, doesn't matter. 10 days after June 30th, that's July 10th, yes, okay? I get a 2%? All right. So we get 2% discount on partial payment. How do we handle partial payments and discounts? Divide by the complement, okay? So take your $1,500 and divide by the complement of the 2% discount. Don't multiply by the 2% and add. That's going to cut you short. So what, 15, 30, 60 something? 61. That's how much my $1,500 is worth. So when I paid that $1,500, it's going to be worth $1,530.61 off the bill. How much do I owe after I make this payment? $28.64.61 subtract. What was that number? 1334. I still owe $1,334. I pay the final amount on the July 20th. What do I write the check for? Am I getting a discount on that July 20th? No. So no discount on 7/20. So you owe this amount, right? It's too late. You should have just waited for the full 90 days or whatever the net terms were due. So pay $13.34 on July 20th. This very classic test type question, right? This is, you know, 20 point question, 5 points for each part. And of course, on the test, I could ask anything of the any of the different types of things up here, right? Don't forget net price equivalent rate or the single equivalent discount rate, right? Both of those are viable things for me to ask. All right, so one more review one just to be safe. All right, so I'm doing a T-shirt shop. Bought 2,000 T-shirts at $5.99 with a 40-15-5 discount, and there are my terms. ROG, what does ROG mean? Receive of goods. Please note that here is when you use the receive goods date instead of the invoice date. All right, so what's my list price? $2,000 times the $5.99. What was that? $11,980. Ooh, what's my net price equivalent rate? Again, multiply by the complements to get that. And again, please do not round this number. Whenever I ask you for either of the types of rates, do not round it at all, okay? So what's 0.6 times 25 times 0.95, somebody? 4845. I'll buy it. So how do I get the list, the net price then? Nicely enough, I set you up. $5,000 what? So $5,804.31. What's my single equivalent discount rate? Yes. And remember that this represents the percent discount that you're actually getting. So this would be like saying that that chain discount of 40.15.5 is really worth 51.55%. Written as one number instead of a chain of three. So what's my discount amount? What's my profit? Remember that the discount amount is your profit from this sale. Two ways you can get this number. What are the two ways? Multiply or subtract, right? You could multiply this times your list price. That'll give you your discount amount, or you can always just take your list price, subtract your net price, get the same number, all right? Whichever one works better for you. If I could write a 5 without scribbling it. 5804.31. What do you get? All right, so now I received my invoice with a date of July 25th. I receive my goods on August 2nd, and And I paid $2,000 on August 8th. So I paid $2,000 on 8-8. What's my discount for my 8-8 payment? 2%. So how am I going to figure out what that $2,000 payment is worth? Get 2% discount. So take 2,000 divided by 0.98. 20, 40, what? 82. And then your 580431 minus 204082. How much do I owe? 37. So $3,763.49 after my $2,000 payment. Woohoo! Now, I pay another $2,000 on the 18th. Am I still within the 2% window? No, sigh. But I am still within the 1% window, right? Keep giving yourself that 1%. So we get a 1% discount on that one. How do I calculate a $2,000 payment with a 1% discount? Same thing, except now use the new complement. Sorry for writing on the bottom of the board. 2020 dollars and 20 cents. Subtract that from how much you owe. So what am I left with? 29 left. And so on the 22nd of August, I make my last payment. On the 22nd of August, I'm still in the 1% window. I haven't completely pissed it away yet. Take that 1%. How do I take 1% off of this payment? Multiply by the complement. Why am I multiplying? Because if you're dividing it, that's when it's a partial payment. This full payment, so multiply by the complement. Right. When it's partial divide, when you're paying it off, right? You're paying it in full and you're still getting a discount, do it the good old-fashioned way, right? So multiply by the complement. So 1% discount on the 22nd. What's my last check for? And again, if you divide this number by 0.99, you'll get back to the 1743.29, right? So again, I mean, be comfortable with the three types of terms, ROG, EOM, and standard. And then remember the difference between partial payments, payments. Because I guarantee you there's going to be at least one partial payment on the test, if not two or three. All right, so this question is actually really good because it gives you just about everything I could ask, all right? Except, of course, this one's all based on ROG instead of EOM or standard. Right, but this is basically Chapter 7 in a nutshell. One question. All right, so questions on the chapter 7 homework? A general question, sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah. If there's no terms, then that means that you didn't negotiate any early sort of payment settlement, so you just get a trade discount and that's all there is to it. And again, depending on the types of negotiating contracts that you have with your suppliers, you may or may not get those early payment discounts, right? I mean, and your chain discount may not be a chain. It may just be always just, you always get 30%. That's all there is to it. I mean, kind of depends on who you're chatting to when it comes to your supplier. 46? Sure. All right, so. Number 46, this is the Verizon cell phone and cellular company. So, Verizon, $99.99 at, what was it? $15.10.5? Or cellular, $102.99 at $25.5? So, and we're going to buy six phones. We want to know what's the difference in the price between these two different sellers. So, for Verizon, how am I going to figure out how much I pay for my Verizon phones? So $99.99 times 6. First, I'm buying 6 of them, right? Now, what's my discount? How am I going to calculate my discount? Or get my list, my net price? Multiply by the complements. And you can do this all in one string. It's perfectly okay. I mean, you don't have to. You can take it one step at a time if you want. But here, what do you get for that one? $4.36 or something? Was there a penny? There is a penny? Okay. $4.36.01. This is your net price, yes. Mm-hmm. So for cellular, so net for Verizon. Now let's do net for cellular. Play the same game. $102.99 times 6 times its complements. 0.75 times 0.95. What am I paying for my cellular phones? 440 something. 440.28. I buy the 28. How much could she save if she buys from the lower priced company? What's her savings? So she should buy from Verizon. $4.27 from Verizon. Note that it's $3 less per phone. But she's only going to save $4.27 because the discount from cellular is much better, right? Getting a 25% discount instead of a 15-10 chain discount, that's better, right? The higher the numbers, the better off. The more smaller your number you have, they're good. You know, never throw away money, but true. All right. One more? 16? Oh, 16, yeah. So my list price, list is $600. No freight charges, yay! Invoice date is 8-1. The terms of the invoice are 3-10, 2-15, and 30. The date of payment is on the 13th. So on the 13th, what kind of a discount do I get? 2%, if I could write the word percent. 2% on 8/13. So how much do I owe? Well, sorry, what's my cash discount? That's just 600 times 0.02. 12 bucks. So how much do I pay? And again, you can do this either way, 600 minus 12 or 600 times 0.98. Either of those are going to give you that your payment is $588. Yeah, the book. I agree. As long as you're doing it right, I'm happy. All right, so if you are happy with your Chapter 7 homework and would like to turn it in, feel free to do so. Please realize you have until Wednesday if you need it. All right, so new stuff. So another type of business that you might run, instead of running a retail shop, is to run what's commonly called a resale shop. A resale shop is what we consider, is probably what you guys consider is the standard type of business model that we run, where when you go to buy something, you go out searching for it, wherever you go, right? You know, whether you go to a different country or you go to a different area, you buy a certain amount of it, and then you mark up the price based on how much you spend, all right? The difference between that, all right, is that this is what's known as a resale shop versus a retail shop, right? So, you know, St. Vinny's, the Goodwill donation stores, those are all more along the lines of your markup type places, right? In fact, Walmart tends to be more along those lines, right? Walmart tends to say, look, I'm going to pay you a certain amount, and then when I get it, based on my costs, I'm going to mark up the price a certain amount. Kind of depends on who's in more control based on the type of business that you run. If the supplier is in control, then you're running a retail shop, right? Because the supplier says, here's your suggested retail price, you sell it at that price. Whereas in these resale shops, you decide, well, if I bought this whiteboard marker for 5 cents, how much should you guys have to pay for it when you come in to buy it, right? Should I charge you a quarter? Should I charge you a dollar? Should I charge you $3,000, right? It's up to me, right? And I will just mark up my percentage, whatever I want from there, okay? So, the three things that you work with in this type of business are the selling price, the cost, and then whatever you marked it up at. All right? I apologize a little bit just because normally I would say it's the price, but we have to call it the selling price. And so what's the first letter of this variable? S. So the selling price, folks, we tend to call capital S. But realize it's the price. Okay? But again, this is the price that you are selling the item at. All right? Again, get in your skull that you're the store owner, right? That's one of the hardest parts of this section of the book is that you guys have to quit thinking like consumers and think like business owners, right? So you get to be the jerk that charges people too much money, right? That's not a bad thing, right? So cost is a C. M is our markup. So what's the basic formula for calculating these sorts of things? My selling price is my cost plus whatever I'm going to mark it up. All right, now, the trick here is that you can mark up your goods in two different ways, okay? And you need to be able to differentiate between the two, all right? So the two different techniques that you can use to calculate your markups is to calculate your markup by cost or to calculate your markup by price. If you mark up by cost, then you calculate your markup by saying, how much did I spend for this item? Whatever percent your markup is, multiply by that. All right? And if you mark up by price, guess what you use to calculate your markup? Deep, huh? Oh, yeah, S. Sorry. Price, I'm immediately going to think P. I'm trying to stay consistent with the book, so I'm switching from P to S. Remind me if I ever write P that I mean S. All right, so these are the two ways that you can calculate your markup. Again, this tends to be the one we're most familiar with, is marking up by cost, right? Because when you buy something, initially you say, okay, I'm going to mark it up by however much I paid for it, and then that's what I'm going to sell it for, all right? The trick to dealing with business, folks, is once you pick a method, you always have to use it anytime you mark up your goods, period, okay? So imagine, if you will, that Walmart marks up by cost. When Walmart goes out and buys, calculators, they probably get them for like $2 a pop, and they mark them up from that $2 probably about 400 to 500% and sell them for like $10, right? What happens when Walmart wants to mark this up or down again? They have to go back to the original cost of the calculator to calculate its new markup up or down. Normally, once we have a price, we tend to mark up from the price. But if you've already said that your business model is to mark up by cost, you can't switch your business model halfway through. Okay? And in fact, the government doesn't allow you to, because it needs to have consistent records on what value add you're giving to all of your goods, because that's how you get taxed at a corporate level. Okay? And that, so businesses, large businesses, mind you, they pick one of the two of these, and then management has to deal with always marking up the right way, period. Okay? Once they've marked up the price initially, getting to the by cost, it's real easy initially. But when they have to mark up a second or a third time, or mark down a second or a third time, whatever they have to do, it's harder, period. Okay? I mean, that's just all there is to it. So a lot of businesses, what they will do is they'll say, screw this, we're going to do everything by price. The first time they mark it up, it's weird, which I will show you. But then once they get the price, going up and down from there, real easy. Okay? So if you start your own resale shop, if you are going to mark things up once and then never change the price, use this. If you are going to mark things up and then change the price continuously back and forth, you want to use this, okay? It kind of depends on whichever business model makes you easier for your life, but the fact remains is you've got to handle both of these depending on which type of business you either run or get hired into, okay? Generally speaking. Okay, so the key here is realizing that So our formula gets a little bit different when we do these two. So if we mark up by cost, right, our markup is cost times the rate. So if we substitute that into our initial equation, what does it become? So take M up here and substitute this instead. What is the selling price? It is the cost plus the cost times the rate. What does this look like, folks? Chapter 6 again, right? Remember what chapter 7 was all about? Yeah, it was all about percentage decrease. Guess what chapter 8 is all about? Percentage increase. All right? So, one of the things that I like to do to point out to you what's going on, all right? Let me give myself some more room here. So if you think back to when we had a rate, right? So imagine if the rate were 20%. If I said I had C plus C times 0.2, what would I do with these two C's? We would add them together. And what would we get if we had 0.2 in there? We have one C here. We have 0.2 C's here. How many C's do I have? 1.2. 1 plus 0.2, right? If my rate was, say, 80%, 1.8, right? So I'm always taking 1 plus whatever the rate is, and then that's multiplying by my cost. The reason I'm showing you this is that I'm going to simplify the equation just a little bit, or maybe not simplify it, depending on how you look at it. So, if you want to figure out what the selling price is, you can calculate the percentage of your cost and then add it back to your cost. Or you can do it a little bit more easily, and just say, well, what is my percentage increase? Add 1 to that, and whatever number I get, multiply by the cost. That is potentially an easier way to go about calculating what the selling price is. Right? Nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with doing things the old-fashioned way. Well, you just take... Now, the reason why I do this, though, is to get cost by itself. So right now, I have the selling price is equal to the cost times this stuff in parentheses, 1 plus the rate. I want to have the cost by itself so that I can figure out how much it cost me initially. How do we undo multiplication? So this formula is the formula that you want to have that relates back to by cost for calculating the cost. So if I give you what I set the price at, but I forgot how much I paid for it initially, and I know that I marked it up by a certain amount, this is the way you go backwards, okay? And generally, if you think about it, when we were dealing with list price and net price, whenever I wanted to go backwards, what did I always end up having to do? Divide by a certain value. Shouldn't be surprised that there's some division going backwards in this world as well. All right, so how does it change when it's by price, though, right? I'm going to play the same game, folks. Right? So same game I played over here, right? I'm going to take this M and substitute what I have here into it, all right? So here, I'm going to take what my M is and plug this stuff into it. So note that this does not look like our standard percentage increase problems. This one is, which is nice. This one, on the other hand, oh crap, it's not the same, right? And the reason why is that over here, my two C's were together. Are my two S's together here? No, they're on the opposite sides of the equal sign. I would really like them to be together. How can I get them together? Subtract one of them over, okay? So what I'm going to do So just like this were 4 or 8 or 16, right? When you subtract 16 from one side, you got to subtract it from the other side, right? So now here's my formula for calculating what the cost is, which is nice. I just take my selling price and subtract the selling price times the rate. I can play this same game again, though, right? When I have the C's here, I can do the same thing with the S's here, right? Except that instead of having plus, what do I get? And if I want, I can now solve for the selling price the same way I was doing over there, except it's slightly different. Or the selling price equals the cost divided by 1 minus the rate. Now, bear with me to some degree. All right. Part of what I'm trying to do here is to just set the table for the formulas that you utilize when you are working with markups. All right? And there are two sets of formulas you have to work up. So, markups. Remember again, folks, you get a note card for this test. The stuff I'm going to write over here on the right-hand side of the board, I'm expecting you to put this on your note card and understand what it means. Okay? So, I want you to write these things down. But more importantly, I want you to understand what they mean. Okay. So the one encompassing formula that you will not forget, and this one is really, 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 really obvious. Please sell your goods for more than you paid for them. All right? So if you tell me that it costs you $8 to buy something and you're selling it for $5, I will be mildly disappointed if you tell me that the price that you're selling for something is less than you paid for it, okay? There's a few companies that can get away with that kind of stuff, and usually when they're doing it, it's because they're trying to kill their competition. If you guys are big enough to do that, I am now your best friend because you've got lots of money sitting around and you can throw it away randomly, okay? So please, this equation is the same no matter what, okay? It's just when you're calculating what you're selling stuff for, start with the cost and add the markup, all right? And then, depending on which type of markup you do, if you markup by cost, this is how you calculate the markup, by cost. If you markup by price, this is how you calculate the markup. It's based off of price, hence the phrase. So when I tell you that I'm marking stuff up, I will always tell you which one I'm using. I'm either marking up by cost or by price. And again, you have to read carefully and, you know, maybe highlight that price or cost word so that you know which column of data to use. All right? So if we're marking up by cost, here is another way to calculate the selling price. And then this formula is what you use to calculate what your cost is if you're given the selling price first, okay? And I guarantee you that you will get some both direction type of problems, right? All right, and here are the two formulas that we're going to play with when we're marking up by cost or by price. Notice they're similar but not the same, right? Again, when you're marking up by price, notice what the rate is always being done with. 1 minus. When you're marking up by cost, notice the way your rate is being worked with. Always 1 plus, okay? And the parentheses are very important. Do not miss them, okay? You guys know how to deal with parentheses because back in Chapter 5, you did the whole distributive property. You know how they work. You know that technically you do the stuff in the parentheses first, then do everything else next, all right? All right, so the next little bit of this class will be us utilizing these formulas. So I'm just basically going to start setting up problems where I'm buying stuff and selling it. Your job is to find the piece of information that's missing, okay? All right, so. All right, so I buy a TV for $56 and mark 81% by cost. What am I going to ask for? Selling price, yes. What do I sell it for? Again, remember that you are a business owner. So when you are buying things as a business owner, these are what's known as costs, hence cost. Okay? So when you read this first portion of this sentence, you should write down, cost is $56. I mark up 81% by cost. Write down what your rate is. It's 81%. Please, 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 please. Pretty please. Tell me that that is the decimal 0.81. So, I am trying to find what is my selling price. So, note, by cost. Which set of formulas over here am I going to use? The ones that are under by cost. Okay, this is how I envision you guys tackling the test, right? Reading the problem carefully, writing down what you have, and then going back to which one you have and utilizing the formulas appropriately. Now, I'm trying to find S. Okay, so under by cost, can I use this formula? Why can I not use this formula? I don't know what my full markup is. Please remember that M is a markup amount, not the markup rate. There's a difference between rate and actual markup. Now, I could calculate this value, could I not? I could if I wanted to. Did I ask for it? No. So is there another formula up there that's you could use that will calculate the selling price in one step? Use it. Find the formula that's going to be easiest. This one's okay. There's nothing wrong with you using this. You could calculate the markup rate and then go back and add. But you've got this one right here. You've got cost. You've got rate. You have everything you need. You can do it in one step as long as you're careful. All right? So basically, take your numbers, plug them into, and this is a parenthesis, and this is the letter C. And folks, you know how to do 1 plus 0.81 in your head. Don't push it into the calculator.
Look at me.
All you're going to do is screw up one of the numbers and get it wrong. Okay? You know what 1 plus 0.81 is. So go do that, okay? I know it's okay to do this, and there's nothing wrong with it. By all means, go ahead, as long as you don't screw up one of the numbers, right? But this is a little bit easier than that. And you guys know how to add one. Trust yourself. I have faith in your ability to add one most of the time. So what am I going to sell this TV for? All right. So, let's try another one. I am selling a toaster for $15.99. I marked it up 72% by cost. What am I going to ask for? How much did I pay for it? Right. Or what are my costs? Same thing. All right, so again, read the problem once, go through it, and then go back and say, okay, what information am I given? I am selling a toaster for $15.99. What are you going to write from that first sentence? Yes, S equals $15.99, because I gave you what the selling price is. Slap it in there. I marked it up 72% by cost. Rate equals 72%, 0.72, and in addition, you're going to take out your multiple colored pen, or you're going to say by cost. What am I asking for? I'm trying to find out what C is, right? What's the only formula inside up here that has C as by itself already? This one at the bottom. And the nice thing about it is, what are the other sides of it? S and rate. And I have those already. Right? So you can say, great, I am going to use this formula. Again, you don't have to write the formula down. I strongly advise writing the formula down, but But you don't have to. I'm happy with just right answers. The more work you show me, the more I can try and guide you. All right? My selling price was $15.99, and my rate, 1 plus 0.72. Again, folks, you know what 1 plus 0.72 is. If you are going to write in the 1 plus 0.72, please make sure that you put the parentheses in there. If you don't, it will be wrong. So, imagine, now I know this is wrong, so don't write this down, okay? Imagine that I punch this into my calculator and I get this number. Right? As soon as you see this, what I want you to do is to say, ah, here's my cost, here's my selling price. What happened in your brain? You're going to say, what the? Okay, I screwed something up. Of course, what you did was that you didn't put the parentheses in. You said 15.99 divided by 1 and then plus 0.72. If you don't put the parentheses in, this is what you're going to get. Okay? So you're going to look at that and say, wait, that can't be right. You're going to repunch the number in, and you're going to get 9.30. All right. Again, it's really just a matter of playing with these formulas. This really becomes algebra playland, okay? All right? Let's see. I mark up a toaster $8.41. My markup is 120% by cost. Find my selling price. All right, so this is where it starts to get fun. In other words, it's slightly tricky. All right. So again, we've read the problem once. Go back to the first sentence. I mark up a toaster by $8.41. What have I given you in this first sentence? Your markup amount. So are you going to write down C or S equals something? No. You're going to say, my markup amount is $8.41. My markup is 120% by cost. This is your rate. Whenever you see a percent on these, the nice part about it is it's always rate. Again, please convert this to a decimal correctly. When you're dealing with markups in resale shops, very, very, very often your markup percentages are going to be more than 100%. In fact, for places like Walmart, the markup is like 600 to 800%. For places like art shops, painting shops, it's the thousands of percents. I mean, this is the way business works, right? I mean, it's literally hundreds of thousands of percent sometimes. Just if you're willing to pay for it, folks, they'll keep marking it up more. All right, now, I need to find my selling price. Of course, first, before you do this, you say, So you're going to work with the by cost side. So here's my selling price. Can I use this formula? Why not? What am I missing? Cost. Darn. So I can go down to this one, right? Well, no, what am I looking for? Right, I'm trying to find selling price, but again, I need cost. Well, crap, I didn't give you cost. We can't do this problem, right? There is no answer, right? Is there a formula that does have markup rate and cost in it? Yes. Use this one to get your cost. All right? So this is a two-step problem. Remember that I like two-step problems. Yes, I am an asshole. Deal with it. So here, this is two steps, right? This is a two-step process. Our first step is to remember that my markup is equal to my cost times my rate, and this is the formula I'm going to use to get my cost, right? So this $8.41 is equal to cost times 1.2. How am I going to get my cost? Divide by 1.2. Pennies. This is money, folks. What was that? $7.01. All right. Now I have my cost. Which formula am I going to use to calculate my selling price? Use the easiest one, folks. Just adding two numbers is really easy. You now have the cost. You have the markup. Use the easy one. You can use this one if you want. There's nothing wrong with it. It'll work. But it's going to take more work to make it work. Don't do more work. Right? So my second step is that my selling price is my cost plus my markup. I paid $7.01 for it. I marked it up $8.41. How much am I going to sell it for? $15.42 toaster. Reasonable, right? Again, read carefully. The hardest problems are when they give you the markup, right? If they give you the selling price or the cost, those problems are always, you can do it in one step. If you're given the markup, it's almost always a two-step process. Almost always. All right? All right. So, by cost, not bad. Let's flip the coin. All right, so let's see. Oh, okay. I buy a pair of shoes for $18.52. I mark up 42% by price. What do I want to know? What's the selling price? Again, please note that this is marking up by price. All right, again, we tend to be set in our ways a lot of times and think that everything is always by cost. Don't trick yourself into doing that. All right? So, we've read the problem. What's the first sentence give us? Cost. You see a percent sign when it's markups, you always know that's just the rate. Again, please convert it to a decimal properly. What am I looking for? Selling price. Because you go over here, and now the set of formulas you use, yoink, buy price. So instead of using the left-hand side, now you use the right-hand side. Can I use this first equation? What am I missing? The markup, right? I don't have the markup amount, I just have the markup rate. Can I use this formula? Yeah, because I have cost and I have rate. It's nasty, but we can do it. We're big boys and girls. We can handle it. So we're going to say, great, my selling price is the cost divided by 1 minus the rate. Yes, it looks a little bit weird. Nothing wrong with weird. Substitute in the numbers. What do we sell these shoes for? $31.93. Again, when you are done with each of these problems, please make that cursory check at the end just to make sure cost and selling price is in the right order, right? Make sure that you paid for it less than you sold it for, right? If you do that, you will always save yourself the points of doing it the wrong way, because that's usually a pretty good sign that you've screwed it up. And the nice part about it is that if you divided by the number and you got the wrong way, guess what happens? If you just multiply by that number, it'll probably take you back to the correct way, all right? More often than not. All right, so I am selling a hat for $35.99. I mark up 53% by price. How much did the hat cost me initially? All right, so again, read the problem. Go back to the first sentence. What did I give you in the first sentence? Selling price, right? If I'm selling something, remember you're the business owner. So the selling price is $35.99. Decent hat. Go to the next sentence. It's 53%. Again, as the business owner, what you paid for something is your cost. Here's your one formula that has cost by itself. You need to have the selling price and the rate. We have that. Excellent. We can get the answer in one fell swoop. Cost equals the selling price times 1 minus the rate. substitute stuff in. 35.99 times 1 minus 0.533. What did I initially pay for this hat? 16.98, is that what I heard? 92. Again, remember, look for this phrase, all right? I will always tell you when we're dealing with markup situations which type my business uses, okay? All right, so one more by price. I marked up a bike by $221.53. My markup is 29% by price. Find my cost and selling price. Technically, it's fair game for me to ask for any of those things. Okay, so we read the problem. What did I give you in the first sentence? I marked up a bike by, right? This is my markup amount. Then I gave you the percent. Again, remember, by price, so we're using the right-hand set of equations. What am I going to find first? Why? You've got the markup and the rate. What's left is the only thing that's got markup and rate inside of it, right? This one with got rate and it has cost and selling price. This one with rate and it has cost and selling price. We don't have both of those. You got to start here. So the first thing you're going to find is the selling price, right? Find S. So 221.53. Equals S times 0.29. How am I going to get my selling price? Divide. Excellent. $53 divided by 0.29. What am I selling this bike for? $763.90. What else do I need? Cost. What formula should I use to find cost? We could use this one. Perfectly okay to use it because it's right there. What else could we do? We have the selling price and the markup. We could find the cost just by taking the selling price and subtracting the markup. That would have been okay. But there's nothing wrong with doing it this way either. It's okay. It'll give you the same answer. Cost equals selling price times 1 minus the rate. $763.90 times 1 minus 0.29. What was that? $542.37. All right. So this gets us started with markups and really just with the markup part of it. We haven't calculated any rates with this yet. We'll go through some of those problems on Wednesday. Please note that next week is test number 2 over chapter 6, 7, 8 on Wednesday. We'll finish 8 on Wednesday in 2 days, and then Wednesday of next week, test 2.
Will we do any review on Monday?
Of course. Joe? Thanks, dude. For those of you that did not